Welcome back to the TI5. I'm still getting set up. Welcome back to the TI5 SEA qualifiers. We've got game two of G Guard up against 5EVA. I'm Basekip, he's Waga, and we've actually got a draft in front of us right now, so let's get straight to it.
Yeah, let's get into this game. We just watched game one of G Guard versus 5EVA, and it was a valiant effort, I feel like, by 5EVA. They tried as much as they could, but they ran into some serious trouble bringing down Yamate. After the early game ganks, he was like, you know what? I'm just not going to die when you guys jump me. I'm just going to be the tankiest flying snake around. So his Viper was just insanely fat. We even reached a point where he had 4k roughly HP with the Granite Golem helping him out. And of course, with the effective HP on Viper as well is ridiculous. So you pretty much have to deal like 8,000 damage to him for him to die. And that's without him healing it up as well. So crazy, crazy game there. And now going into this draft, we see a little bit of a different approach. We're still back. Undying is being banned out first by Chibix, Gyrocopter, and Draw Ranger being banned out by Yamate. This is one of those we use the hero and win with it, and then we ban it. We see it sometimes in competitive games where you, in a best of two series and best of three series, you will make use of something that's really strong and then ban it out, and like you can't do the same thing that we just did to you, because that's very popular. If you see one thing stomping in the first game, very often second game the other team will maybe steal it or try and throw their own adaptation of that strategy.
I mean, there's extra value as well to taking away a hero, right? If you're like, okay, well, they played it extremely well in the previous game. We now know that they value it. And if you think it's also a strong hero and being able to take it away from the other team, I think always worth consideration. And I think also this time around it's 5EVA with the... Yeah, 5EVA with the first pick, so makes a little bit more sense as well from that context.
And Queen
G Guard to
gonna be played.
Out. Yeah, Queen
I'm really
makes
happy
it
to see Queen. She's one of my favorite heroes to watch. As she's just interesting to see how far people can push her, and she has the potential to fight really well, which I like in this current meta. She also brings a lot just by being level 7. She has tons of damage to throw into a team fight. The ulti is massive AoE as well, so pretty easy to execute. But, of course, easy to execute, but pretty high skill cap, I feel. Comes down to how well you calculate your blink cooldown duration and how much you can tank during the downtime. So, Viper is going to be respect banned by Chibix here in the second phase. Shadow Demon being removed as well. On the G-Guard side, Lesh and Naga Siren being removed. So, no Miracle Naga in this series.
Yeah, and G-Guard going to end up picking up a hero that I am always... so happy to see. It's the Beastmaster. I don't know if we're going to be seeing it played mid here necessarily. I have seen Yamate play mid Beastmaster in the past, but that may have been quite a while ago. But Walker, give me your 2 cents on this.
I think that they're going to run it offlane. It's still probably the most viable, but mid is really strong as well. Beastmaster is very versatile. You can even run him as support if you want. Maybe not the greatest support in this patch, but he was really good in 6.82, 6.83 as a support. I like the hero, and I think he's super strong after the changes he got. The extra damage helps his mid lane quite a bit. The off lane is roughly the same. Mm-hmm. As for the boar, it's just a monster right now. You can dominate lanes with the boar. So you can outlast hit a queen if you get high level on it. Like when you're level 2 already with the damage between Beastmaster and the boar, you can out CS a queen. So... we'll see how they want to lane it and what they want to do. Of course, you have to stay on top of your micro and not, you know, run too far ahead, because the board does feed 59 experience, I believe, which is massive. You don't want to die with that against your mid laner if you're going that lane. And they once again, really heavy stunts being picked up, this time by G-Guard with the Lina and Shaker, which of course 5EVA had in the previous game, and adding up the Beastmaster instead of a Leshrac to have some single target lockdown, which I really appreciate. I think this is a better combination than the Lina and Lesh. I never really see them working well together. The two of them just fill too much of the same role, I think.
Yeah. I like the Beastmaster a lot, in particular against this opening that 5EVA gone for with the Queen of Pain and the Lion. Just having the Hawk against anyone who's blinking in or, you know, coming in into a team fight while trying to stay hidden at the start, the Hawk is always going to be amazing. You see the Queen of Pain coming in, you can even be pre-casting Roar, so as soon as she lands, you're interrupting the chain of initiation, same kind of story for Lion. Yeah. And I feel like that's where a couple of months ago we were with Beastmaster. People were picking him up occasionally to sort of scout Axe and
do you think
make
they
life
go
difficult for him.
Do you think they want to go full crazy and pick up like a Tinker and have offlane Beast and then the Yamate Tinker?
Like I'm down for some Yamate Tinker. That could be.
I would not mind seeing it. And of course,
but it's so hard against Zeus and Lion.
Okay,
I think.
It's gonna be the other. I'm gonna say the other combination, pretty much. Beastmaster and Shadow Fiend is a great combo. You both have the attack speed aura, which is really strong now, and you have the minus damage, minus armor aura as well. So your physical DPS is gonna be amazing. A hero like Lina can right click really well in this game.
Oh yeah, that's actually very true. I hadn't considered that. Do you think that the Beastmaster aura changes the Shadow Fiend's build priorities at all? I mean, obviously your start
slightly
is pretty much always going to be the same. There's sort of two build paths at the moment, but does it shift things more towards Skadi? Do you start considering stuff like Daedalus, which has been very forgotten on Shadow Fiend, or you think it's just going to be very standard?
I think you could go for, like, later on, I think Daedalus and itemizations like this is going to be fine. He just needs a high HP pool so that he doesn't get burst down by all the damage. Because there's Queen, Zeus, and Bloodseeker. These heroes hurt. Even Lion, possibly Lion with Enrage on, Blood Rage on him. So you have tons of damage potential from 5 Eva, and you need to tank up your SF. But I think he could go for Blink Yules in this game if he wants to. There are some good targets. Queen is easy one-shot for SF if he wants to. And there's only really two good heroes to stop him, Lion and the Zeus. And all you need to know is that they're not in range to run there. They don't really have early Blink Daggers as opposed to your Blink Yules on Shadow Fiend. So he could go for that path, or he could go for the more standard, I'm going to say, the build leaning towards the mech BKB, and then into whatever item. Very commonly, either Skadi, Satanic, or Butterfly. Butterfly, not the option in this game, though. You definitely don't go mech BKB Butterfly against this lineup.
I don't think that's the build.
Because you need HP, like raw HP, and even maybe some resistance if he wants to. If he feels he has an inventory slot, he could go for a casual cloak, but you don't really have that as a mid laner. You run out of inventory slots. Okay. Abaddon. We had some discussions on the couch on how important it is.
The pronunciation stuff is always the worst.
The worst discussions.
It's just like, everybody thinks they're right. It's
exactly.
People argue from the strangest backgrounds as well. It's
exactly.
Like, oh, in French, it's pronounced this way, but in
visage or visage. Yeah. It's good fun. I enjoy listening to bullshit like this. Oh, that's cool. They ban out the Abaddon against their own Beastmaster, and then as they have the Beastmaster, they go for Ursa. So this way they have a very good counter to Bloodseeker.
They can blow up anyone.
Yeah, Bloodseeker in particular is the type of hero that runs in the outskirts of the fight and throws his spells and runs in for the finish all the time.
Gets a heal,
backs
out, gets a heal.
Exactly. He's that kind of, you know, like, I don't know how to call it, just a very special type of hero in the way that he executes. But if you just keep the Beastmaster ulti online and save that for Bloodseeker in most cases, or even a Yule Scepter on Lina, you can just stop the Bloodseeker in his track, get a stun on him, and then Ursa can blow him up so fast. He actually kills him immediately.
Yeah, and G-Guard's Roshan potential now is ridiculous. They've got pretty good fight around the pit with the Earthshaker.
They have scouting
from Beastmaster.
They have to check level 1 Roshan even in this game. Like, sure, it's not the best level 1 Rosh, but anytime you see an Ursa on the enemy team, if you don't check Roshan, you're going to beat yourself up if you lose to something like that. And also, of course, you have to be careful for the wraparound, like the fake Roshan. Because, But I think 5 Eva have a great level 1 lineup. They're really strong. They have the Windrunner, they have the Bloodseeker, everything they need to fight early on. Even Queen of Pain is a great level 1 hero.
Yeah.
So I think they're fine to contest there.
And we talked about the synergy between Zeus and Bloodseeker as well. So I think there's some other strong points from 5 of his lineup that we haven't necessarily touched on yet.
Even, I mean, Miracle plays a beastly Windrunner. I've seen some highlight clips of this guy.
Oh, yeah.
Like, he's insane on that hero as well. So looking for him to make plays with 4 staff. He really likes to go for 4 staff and blink, but he could, of course, go for the more standardized Aghanim's Rush and then into a DPS item. I would love to see him go for the utility kind of approach, though. I think he could make more happen with that. But I'm excited about this game already as that last pick came in.
Yeah, I want to see some shackles. That's all.
Definitely. I mean, yeah. I recommend, if you haven't seen the highlight reels of Miracle Windrunner, you should go to YouTube and check them out. He plays it really well. One of his most played heroes as well. Can I check his profile, or does he have it hidden? There's a possibility you have it hidden, right?
Let's see.
Oh, he actually has it open, so you can go in and check. TA, Invoker, and Naga are his most played, but
what's he been playing recently? I guess these are all disqualified. Oh no, a lot of ranked. They don't show up.
You won't see the qualifier games. You just see the ranked games and so on. He's a type of player that plays everything quite a bit. He just mixed up a lot. Tons of SF.
There are a few pages of SF and Quap in there.
Yeah, quite a bit. He hasn't been playing Windrunner for a very long time in his ranked games, but again, before TI, you probably scrim a shit ton. So these games date back pretty long back, and most of his games are probably in scrims at this point.
He's probably been pretty busy. I'm sure practicing.
He
up
plays
as much
a
as he
lot
can.
Of Dota. Just wanna mention. Some people don't have that many games in their.
I mean, he's got
in their lists.
He's got 4,000 wins.
Yeah.
So
he has a lot of games. This guy.
Yeah.
4K wins.
What are you at these days, Walker? How many games?
I think I have like 3,200 wins. So he actually has more pubs played than I have. I feel beat, dude. Fucking Miracle. What a player.
There you go. He's still young. He's still he's still got the energy to play 20 pubs in a day.
Crazy dude. Crazy.
Oh well. CS:GO later. The 5-ever guys are already just making plans with G-Guard.
CS:GO later, Maling. Okay. They're setting up their CS scrims. Shadow Fiend rocking them swaggy arms. New Immortal. Pretty cool stuff.
You know, heroes pick rates always go up a little bit when these new cosmetics come in.
I'm looking forward to seeing some anti-mage. I actually got
Lakels could play some anti-mage.
True.
I could see that.
I got so lucky yesterday. I opened my chests. I got the anti-mage golden on the first drop, and then I opened 5 more, and I got it again. So I actually have dupes of it. But I didn't get the SF arms, though, so I'm going to have to trade someone for that. We'll see. I'm sure I can find someone.
I'm sure you'll have no problem.
Roshan is being checked by Radiant, of course, as expected here. They just poked around and made sure that no one is there. They also got vision of people up on top for a brief moment, so they'll be fine. Oh, Miracle has the Killing Blade. He's doing Ancients, dude.
Oh, wow. This is...
He's doing Ancients. So this is solo mid Queen of Pain, offlane / Ancients.
This is like...
Windrunner.
This is TI3 Na'Vi strats.
Yeah, sort of. Oh, he goes for it.
He's
going to
get
it. He gets it.
Oh, he gets it.
That's massive.
Miracle.
That's
okay,
so good.
That's huge, actually. So both Bouncy Runes going to 5-ever there.
Yeah.
Cheeky little play with the Windrun, but G-Guard were not at all expecting a solo hero from 5-ever to come and contest that.
And this is not a great matchup mid. Yamate is going to be Ursa against Queen.
Melee hero against a Quap.
Queen is always a very strong hero at punishing people, so this is going to be tough. I mean, obviously he has the poor man shield and it's hard to harass, but... You only have 2 tangos for HP regen, and what are you going to do after the Shadow Strike is level 2?
He's running at her at the moment.
Yeah. Well, he can deal a lot of damage just by running at her now, but it's more like when Queen is level 3, you really suffer on this lane.
Yeah, once the Shadow Strike starts getting leveled up, it's going to be dangerous. Ben's already got his double boar up bottom lane, trying to grab a few CS. The Chaos is just right-clicking them down. They're not particularly tanky at level 1 with 0 armor, so... New base damage lion gonna keep putting on some pressure. Does have the creep wave pushing towards them right now, so that makes a little bit more space for him. But not an amazing start for the Beastmaster necessarily. As Miracle is just settling into
Ling is
auto
like Miracle,
ancients.
Where you at, bro? Are you over here? Shaker just going out and confirming like, yep, that's a dude, and he's here to steal experience, of course.
If I go too much further, this Queen of Pain might blink and shadow strike me. So let's just stay.
He actually. Right. Didn't get experience from that one. Was it too far, or can you simply...
No, you can't soak ancients.
Oh, you can't soak
them at all. It's only regular neutrals that you can steal from.
Oh, yeah. True.
So Miracle is actually totally covered here, even if Ling sits here.
Yeah, and there's no way he can even kill him here. So Ling is just going to sit around.
Have they both seen one another? The Fodder Cocky still
sitting? Yes, they saw each other.
Okay, so they've both spotted... Being spotted on both sides. Pelosin actually eats a Fissure and some nukes on mid lane.
I think this might just be a lane switch, right? Because Yamate, how are you going to keep laning on mid? You have no HP at all, which is making Bloodseeker super strong and very easy last hits for him on bottom right now. I don't think you stay on mid. I think you go jungle as Ursa right now. Just disappear off the map. That also makes it easier to go into Roche pit, because that way you can sneak into Roche without anyone really noticing. Are they gonna make? They're gonna try and make a wraparound here on Miracle, but I don't know how effective it's gonna be. He did see the
ES. ES was spotted on the ward. Yeah. So.
Oh, he needs to back now though. But Lina. Oh, Lina did block, but I don't think that matters much. Windrunner
still has quite a few creeps.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. There are still many creeps, and he's getting so much more than he would get on the offlane. Besides, Shaker hasn't been doing much. He hasn't been protecting mid. He did help mid a little bit, but he didn't really win it for the Bloodseeker by any means. Or for the Ursa by any means. And he doesn't really mess with Miracle either. Miracle is just going to be farming here.
Okay, so 5-0 really settling into some pretty decent farm. KS is running pulls and pulls through on the bottom lane as well. They've got plenty of opportunities. Once Chibix has a few more levels for him to start moving over into the jungle, and they can start working towards the Blink Dagger on the Lion. So I like the overall game plan here from 5-EVA, honestly.
Yeah, I feel the same. I think they can get a lot done with this. And they just need to get level 6 on Bloodseeker, and then bottom lane is going to be a pain for Ben as well. He can't really do much against that. But he's going to try and deny his own boar, but does get killed by the Arc Lightning there. Some nice gold and experience.
Oh, random stun landing onto Plus in mid lane. Wasn't even necessarily set up. TP coming in as well from net. Raise 4 HP on the Queen of Pain. That was... Oh, Fisher from him. Ling from long range. I keep forgetting how huge this Fisher is these days.
Yeah, the extra range on Fisher when they added that is a big deal. So really nice there. Well played. And I think they're going to switch up Miracle to top now because they see the switch from Ursa, right? You never want to let go and let this Ursa have an easy time. So just go up here, buy some boots on Miracle, and start pressuring Ursa again. Deal damage to him so that he can't free farm. It's really important. They seem to have a good mentality in this game, 5-EVA.
Yeah, it seems like it's a little bit more lane focused. They're keeping a better track, I think, of what G-Guard's goal is in this game and trying to disrupt that a little bit.
I would like to see more pulls being done bottom though by Lion. I wish he would keep just focusing fully on himself and get as much levels as possible so that he gets early Blink Dagger and level 6.
Okay, Zeus, you've got the Illusion Dream. Let's see some sick double stack action here.
Yeah, he can do it, I believe. He can just share with Miracle. Miracle can like lane top and stack 5 neutral camps at once. I believe
the wraparound from Ling, but once again this Radiant Ward is going to scout things out really nicely and Miracle just comes running at him.
Yeah,
sort of giving away the fact and that the Earthshaker was spotted, but
they miss one of the stacks. The left one, I believe, is going to be missed. That was really late. Oh, they actually got it. Wow.
Oh, wow.
They attacked on 54 and a half, so it was just barely going to get it. But
Miracle.
Nice.
Okay, might be some trouble here. The fish is going to land. Lightstrike Array follow up. He's still got the wind run, and we'll just be able to TP out here, in fact. Okay.
Oof. That was very close.
Needed, I think, one more auto attack to finish him off.
Good presence of mind there, just counting the CD on Winter's stun. He knew that he could just barely make it out in time. Winter just had his stun as Miracle disappeared.
All right, so what have we got going on? Looks like the we've already got the Bloodseeker making his way over to the jungle. Ben has kind of realized that the Bloodseeker's not here, so he can play a tiny bit more aggressively and start to pick up a little bit of additional farm, but still only level 3.5. At this stage of the game.
It's going to free up more space for Lion as well to farm, though. Lion's going to be super happy with this.
Nice
self-deny. Yeah, exactly. Some stacks being done in the jungle here.
Oh, Miracle comes running out of nowhere. Net not going to be shackled, but I don't think they even needed that to land. He's already been Shadowstruck up. Ling's coming in to try and save this with the Fissure, but the Sonic Wave ensures it. And Plus and Miracle walk away with that kill.
Yeah, very nice rotation. After he got forced to TP back home, you might as well try for a gank. And did work. Bloodseeker now with an Invis rune is looking to make something happen. Can they get a shackle here? Gonna need to shackle Lina if they can, but might just kill him. He's straight up dead, I think. Power shot. On point. Good execution here, and you don't really expect that. Like, who expects a level 5 Bloodseeker to come with an Invis rune and gank you? That's so unlikely. So, they're just finding that off-chance gank.
Feels like 5-EVA are playing a little bit like TNC. I think TNC, the couple of games that I've cast from them, one game I saw a 3-man gank at mid, feature including the offlaner, a minute and a half into the game. And then the very second game of theirs that I cast, they did a 4-man dive mid, like 4 minutes in. And
yeah.
5-EVA kind of doing the same thing, just lots of rotations and lots of pressure on the middle lane right now.
Yeah, it's not uncommon in the current patch, I mean, to see these kind of ganks. You see, of course, Bloodseeker farming some stacks here in the jungle. And there are stacks in the jungle for Shadowfiend as well now. So he can go out and clear. Or they already clear
I
them.
Think he's already taken them.
They failed one of them. They failed the medium camp one, and the other medium camp is stacked, but it's mud golem, so it's not amazing. Good deep ward here by Ling. This is going to try and keep track a little bit more of where Miracle is going to head. Of course, he might just TP out this time, go somewhere. We'll see.
Yeah, it does suggest, well, this would be the right kind of ward if they were looking to put a little bit more pressure on this top tier one and spot potentially mid heroes or supports making their way up towards defending. But G-Guard don't have the most impressive tier one push lineup here. They kind of have to bring the Shadow Fiend to the Beastmaster, I think, to really look towards that tower. And I don't think Yamato's too interested in pushing right now. Probably just wants to keep farming safely.
Yeah, no, Yamato doesn't want any attention towards him, basically. He just wants to stay calm. The ward that they just placed did scout out Miracle moving towards top, but however, I don't think they know Queen of Pain is here. She is not revealing herself. She actually blinks in very aggressively. That's not going to do much.
Yamate's like, okay, this I don't like this. It's Roshan time.
Yeah, TP's away and goes Roshan.
That's actually a pretty big deal because right now the Queen of Pain probably thinks he's just hiding in the fog because he got Shadowstruck. And from his perspective, it's like, okay, Ursa is just afraid that he's getting ganked.
He's like, yeah, Ursa was just here. I pressured him a little bit, and now we'll see where he is.
So here's moving through. They might think that these are both illusions, perhaps.
Oh, she might get that. She can blink after. Yeah, she got it. Nice Fisher kill, Fisher, but they do get the Courier kill, which is huge. In terms of golds, you get a lot for your team killing a Courier.
Mini tower.
Yeah, mini tower. Mini Roshan, dude. Roshan, speaking of which, is being killed right now by Ursa. Not going to use his ulti as all, holding it on. Doesn't really need it when he has a Beastmaster attack speed there. And the ulti is just so useful for fighting now.
Net's getting ruptured on mid lane, just staying still for now. Lightstrike is going to keep things zoned back somewhat, but
so fast.
In comes the Sonic Wave. They burst one down, and the Bloodseeker just one shot and finishes off the Lina. There's going to be a roar coming in. It looks like Chibik should fall in the end.
He started buying a Dagon.
Really?
Yep.
Oh, man.
It's a Dagon build. I disagree wholeheartedly with the Dagon choice, but it's his choice. That's, you know, his decision making. So in the C qualifiers, currently 7 wins and 0 losses, has been banned 6 games out of 30, and played 7, I assume, then. So pretty high pick slash ban rate.
Yeah, 50% pick ban.
And yeah, I think this is the first time I see the Dagon build, though. Obviously, I'm not against Dagon on Bloodseeker in general. I just don't like it as your first item. I think it's really bad as a first item for Bloodseeker. Going this into anything like Midas or Yule Scepter early on is great, or even the two of these items. But we'll see what he can make happen with it. I'm not going to judge him until I've seen his performance on it.
Yeah. He could just play around it perfectly. And I mean, that's always the great thing about Dota, right? You've got heroes and you think, okay, these are the standard builds, but some people tweak things just ever so slightly. And the first time we see it, we're like, oh, okay, you know, that's really weird. I don't quite agree with it.
Yeah.
And then it becomes the standard you know, a couple of weeks later. So.
Definitely. Well, later on, I wouldn't mind at all to see him pick up the Dagon. I think it's a great item for your type of playstyle on Bloodseeker later. It's just that you kind of need to be even faster.
Oh, Miracle. Nice sidestep on the Lightstriker at top, leading into the Shackle off the creep. Oh. And that's going to be a free kill for him.
That was a Miracle Shackle shot. And he kind of runs into a lot of people here, but he can just windrun and run away. Miracle just giving Winter the place. Winter has been having a hard game. He's 0-3 and 2.
Ben, his TP's on cooldown, but I don't know if I've ever known that. He's still just juking. Shibix is like, okay, he's definitely here.
You're not fooling Mr. Bloodseeker. He can smell it, dude.
Keep running, Ben. Keep running.
Chaos
doesn't actually have any spells.
Nothing. He's like, yeah.
No, okay. He's trapped in the trees. Uses the roar to knock the Bloodseeker away. Just going to try and auto-attack the Beastmet. Auto-attack the Lion down. Winter comes in. That's Stuckery not going to land. The Rupture comes out. Pelosin also joining in on the fun as Yamate comes charging in with his Aegis at the ready.
Yamate's like, I have Aegis, fight me. But he's going to get some action indeed. Fisher being used now. Maybe they can go on the Ursa instead, but they're trying to pursue. Has the ulti here. Queen going to go for a solo kill on Shaker. Brings him down.
Yeah, does manage to grab it and blink cooling down pretty quickly, so doesn't have to be all that afraid of the Ursa. Just going to give him one last Shadow Strike as a goodbye.
Finds a good rune as well. DD rune just around the corner. Very nice for him. He almost has the second Oblivion Staff as well. He's building towards his Orchid. Dagan now completed on Bloodseeker.
They're going to try and gank top lane. But Earthspike is very short as Net just backing up to go and grab
KS
the back.
KS with the ambitious.
Yeah, that was Spike. That was hopeful. Blossom diving mid with this double damage. He's got another blink. Doesn't want to use it just yet. Jumps over the top. Doesn't get the scream off, though. No. That's going to leave Ysera for dead as Yamate just punches him down. Chibix is coming in. A few more auto attacks come out. Does manage to get the heal. Blossom still plinking away with the double damage as the rupture does end up coming out. That's actually
they
over
don't really
on the
have
Shadow
more
Fiend.
People, though. It's only the two of them. And
he's still got the mech.
Oh, I think this is
over-ambitious.
Chainstun,
Laguna Blade.
Yeah, that was over-ambitious. The two of them should just be happy with the fact that they managed to kill the Ursa. That was a good play. And the fact that Ursa could turn there at all was attributed to his new change to the ulti. Being able to reduce 80% damage, he just completely disjointed, you could say, the nuke from Zeus, and Queen couldn't finish him off. So strong ability. And Force Staff is completed as the first item on Miracle. So this goes to show how much he likes this build. Oh, they're going to go for a kill on him. I think he's dead straight up. You can auto-attack across here. Even using the ES ulti, he doesn't need it.
Okay, mass TPs from 5EVA. Can they actually catch anybody? Ben's already made his way out. Chibix is going to keep up the pursuit. The Dagon gives him a bit of extra move speed as he knocks down the Earthshaker that little bit more, and Ysera is going to finish things off.
Yeah, securing with the Zeus ulti. You want to be careful stealing too many kills from a Bloodseeker, though, because he really relies on getting his kills when he starts rotating. He wants to get the last hit, not the...
Especially with this kind of a build with the Dagon.
Exactly.
It's not a farming item by any means. He needs to continue finding hero kills nonstop.
Interesting build, really. The Treads, Bottle, and Dagon. I can't say that I would want to replicate this, but it's not... You know, it's a hero with options. Can definitely go with this.
Ysera got spotted trying to run around behind to place this ward here, so Ben's going to ping it out. They had a Hawk in position, but looks like Ysera is going to be able to retreat himself back. KS has his Blink Dagger up notably right now, and he's going to go jumping in. Finger of Death Dagon on your poor Beastmaster. Just gets popped. Nice little play. They even Blood Rage the Lion to make sure that the Finger of Death did a ton of damage.
Dagon kills two.
Yeah, we've got the running tally.
Yeah,
I wonder if he's going to level it up at all, or if it's just going to... I don't want to see it leveled
up. I reckon you keep it. Yeah, you definitely don't level it. Just because we say that, he's probably going to go ahead and do it and run around with no HP at all for the entire game.
I mean, if you're one-shotting people...
Yeah, but you can get one shot as well. That's the downside to it.
Yeah.
Blink Dagger completed online is really nice for him now. He's going to completely whiff it, though, and jump into entire enemy team.
If he'd gotten the Earthspike off a little bit faster, would have probably stunned three, but still died anyway with
He would still die because the Shaker can run him down and Fissure him if he uses Blink aggressively like that. And that puts Shaker closer to his Blink being part of this kill. He has 1,700 gold, so slowly working his way. He might even
bottom lane, they're looking for the Bloodseeker to hear a Smoke Gank wrapping around. They've got the Roar. They're going to lock him down. And that's going to be the end of him. As G-God actually TP in a bunch. They've got the mech available on the Shadow Fiend. And looks like they want to just try and transition this into a tier 1 tower push. 5EVA are finding an answer, however, as they start going for a tier 1 tower of their own over on the mid lane.
Yes. So, pressure being applied. Just trying to go for a tower. And both of them last hitting. It's kind of funny to see.
I want it.
Miracle and Poloson not really agreeing who should have the gold, but Poloson gonna take it in the end.
He's actually closer to another item. I guess it's relatively close. They've both just finished up kind of their first big ticket item. Miracle probably wants, I guess, his point booster now.
Point booster or Blink. I mean, I think he's going to go Blink, honestly, as his next item. That would be the Miracle style. Even a Shadow Blade next wouldn't be too bad. But we'll see what he goes for.
Built first in exactly three games.
First item, 66% win rate. That's reliable stats.
Well, there we go. Let's see, Chibix, can you...
From the great pool of three games. We'll see if he makes it, 50, or if it's going to keep improving it up to 75%. Go, Bloodseeker. Best of luck.
It's the build. We'll find out. G-Guard going for a smoke here. There is a Queen of Pain illusion.
Oh, they actually disjointed through. Oh, my God. They thought it was real because the smoke broke.
Yeah.
But that's just because Pelosin is sitting around here. Oh, he messes up. Oh, he ran wrong.
He ran the wrong way. He gets roared. Yeah. He's going to get focused. Lightstrike Ray also clips him on the back of the head.
That's just sad. He blinked and then he started, he misclicked his movements. Oh, I was just about to praise you, Polosum, for making such a nice play. Then you do this to me. Oh well.
Oh well. Come on, let's go. Finger dig on kill time. KS and Chibix mid lane. Winter already gone. Chibix doesn't get to use the Dagon.
That's a Blood Rage Lion, right? So yeah. it hurts quite a
Chibix
bit.
Chibix just juking in the trees. He's looking for Ling. Ling manages to blink out with nothing canceling that. Earthshaker actually has his Blink Dagger up at the moment, so he's doing very well on farm.
Yeah, which means they can keep pursuing here. They have Blink Dagger on Ursa as well, so they just straight up kill this guy. I think this is this is sort of the weakness that I'm talking about. What? Yamato dropping his TP Skull and attack canceling his... I don't know what he's doing. He's threatening his TP Skull to kill it.
It's just some ice tactics, right?
I guess.
Now Pelosin comes jumping in with the Orchid Silence onto the Shadow Fiend, but just rankles him down. Shackle Shot, however, lands on both. And looks like Ysera, along with Miracle, are going to be able to clean this up. KS comes blinking out of the side to do exactly what his name says and finish that kill.
And he lives as well on the Zeus, just barely. And Miracle doing again what we said. We talked about it before we started casting this game. The Miracle is just a beast, right? He's just a really standout player, possibly one of the most standout players in the C qualifier. So really great play there. He has a Maelstrom completed now, so suddenly adding a lot of DPS, making his ulti much more potent as well. I wouldn't blame him for any item build that he decided to go for, because he's such a Windrunner tryhard that his decision making is probably, whatever build he goes for is probably the most effective for this game.
Yeah, and he likes the split push as well quite a bit, so I think it makes sense for him to pick up this Maelstrom and gives him a little bit of extra pressure to push out the lanes. And that's going to be important since G-Guard had such a five-man oriented kind of a lineup. I mean, you see this Necro Book on the Beastmaster, and you can really kind of read into their intentions from that. We've got another jump being lined up top lane. KS and Chibix waiting for a second Blood Rage, perhaps? No, okay, it's only level 2 at the moment, so they can't actually get multiple up.
Yeah, exactly. Same duration as cooldown right now. When you have it maxed out, then 12-second duration, 6-second CD. It's very nice. So right now I feel that 5EVA are slowly taking control of the game. But they need to be careful with dying on key heroes like Bloodseeker or Queen, because it gives away a lot of golds. And Queen blinking ultra-aggressive there in the last fight is an example of that.
Net, he thinks that they've given up on him, but they haven't, KS. Oh,
no, he's on. He was still fading when he walked in there. Actually, they have a hawk. Wow, the casual alt chat high.
Casual alt chat high.
Oh, net. Man. Yeah. We don't have a translator for this. This is... No. I feel like he needs more vowels than that, honestly.
I think he's actually... I don't even think it's any other language. I think it's just, I'm not there, la.
Oh, that could that could be it. I'm not there, la.
Ling jumps in with the echo, but he doesn't actually land it on Chibix. Short range just to blink somewhere, and now the finger comes flying out of the trees. Another shackle for Miracle. Going to keep net locked in place. KS running forward will get auto attack down, and it's just a blink support for a blink support as the Lion and the Earthshaker are going to trade lives.
Yeah, just some life trading. More commitment, though, from G-Guard as they brought in more people there. And this allows, of course, the Queen of Pain to split push more on bottom lane. Zeus is still farming up. He has a 4-staff as well. I love these 4-staff pickups. Oh, my God.
I'm definitely not here.
Yeah, they don't have any vision, so they're just going to chill.
Well, just hope that this isn't the Beastmaster's Necro 3 on the courier.
Yeah, they just
okay,
have...
Okay, no, it's not. It's just the BKB. All right.
Coming in. Chibix, definitely not there. Bottom lane, going really aggressive here. 4-staff going to help save the Queen of Pain. He has ulti. Can I go for the kill?
Yeah, turns around for the Sonic Wave. Gets a few more auto attacks out. Does manage to get Ling, but Yamate pops up from the grave and finishes him off with a blink coming in. Miracle walking past two heroes over in the dire jungle, and he's not tanky enough to live through a roar and a Laguna Blade.
He was pushing mid, and then he runs straight into enemy jungle. That's one of those straight up bad plays.
Oh, Net manages to get off the BKB as KS comes jumping in. Okay, we've once again got a little bit of back and forth.
This has turned into an alt-head game. I like it. I approve. Very good timing there on the impale, though. If the BKB was to end, that was the last possible moment to impale off the TP. So, good attempt by KS, but this was a first BKB charge. They last forever. 10 seconds confirmed. Eternity.
The blink in Dota, it is. Yeah. 10 seconds is an extremely long time in a Dota timescale.
It was a little bit of a misplay by Polison again there on bottom lane, just blinking during the Aegis on Ursa, so that when Ursa respawned, he could just blink on top of the queen and she had cooldown. If he just held onto it, he would probably have been fine and could probably still go for the kill on Shaker. But it's easy to analyze from the bird's perspective, right? We see everything. He doesn't have all the intel. But 5 deaths now on your solo mid queen is going to really give some momentum back. This is a really even game once more. We're still at like 0 difference at all.
Thunder God's Wrath gets popped, charging up the Bloodseeker somewhat.
Necrobooks didn't see the work. Oh, top.
Net getting silenced up, but Ling is here to help out. We got some more Ulchad coming out.
These two teams.
Oh, I you know what? I really love seeing this. Because Dota, end of the day, best kind of Dota is playing with your friends, against your friends. It's all good, right?
It seems that they're having fun at least, so that's good. They're going to probably kill the Shadow Fiend now. Yeah.
Okay, this time around they get the Blink Hex coming in, silenced up, but Net does manage to pop the PKB and turns around. In comes the Echo Slam from Ling. Pelosa not quite finished off, does manage to blink a little bit further away.
How did he not Earth Spike him after getting a Hex off? I don't understand. This is a 2.5 seconds you have to stun him, but he just held on to Earth Spike. Okay.
Okay, Chimix, time for the re-engage. He's healing up a little bit. I think he wants Net. He can auto-attack and Dagon, but I don't think that's quite going to be enough.
Almost.
Instead,
he's
going to go for Ling, but Ling does have a Fissure. So yeah, he needs to try and bring in the Earthshaker first if he can. Puts the Blood Rage up to go for the Dagon, but that might cost him his life. Does manage to blink out of the Blood Rage. Very nicely played by Ling, and Net waiting in the side chop. Just one last casual raise. And Ling's like, sad face.
Sad face. Well...
Ling gets his blink once he gets back to base.
Yeah, well, Ling already had his blink. It's not even that. He has his Staff of Wizardry now. It was blink on Net being purchased now. So blink BKB mech build.
He blinked away from the Blood Rite. What am I talking about?
Exactly. It's fine. Mid, some damage being dealt here by Pelosan onto the Yamate. He has a BKB and he could just scare him away. That's a 10-second charge, though. They're really... I don't want to say generous. Oh, are they going to try? I don't want to say generous, but they really get forced out to use their 10-second BKB charges easily in these games. And that's a massive thing. Having the long BKB durations for the team fights is pretty big deal. This game is not about team fights, though. This game is just skirmishes all over the place.
Yeah, 5-ever just running around, I don't want to say willy-nilly, because they are definitely looking for specific targets, but yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Pelosan finds out Ben down bottom lane and
help from Zeus, of course, bringing some extra damage. And DD rune on Queen is very, very useful. So, smoke being used here, and it was scouted out by KS standing on the cliff on the other side. He did get the intel, so he's drawing pretty much.
They
exactly.
scribbled all over the map. I can't even
he's
see
like
them.
This way. I don't even know where they're going, but this way, guys.
This is a vague direction. Yeah. But Yamate leading the way. Ling down here as well. Doesn't have the Echo Slam for 20 seconds, but. Still want to try and find a kill if they can. They're even going for the, okay, let's use the smoke to see if anybody's farming this camp down the hill.
Yeah.
And we can jump over.
They have a lot of blink daggers, so they could definitely fight there. They have 3 of them, right? Yeah.
Yep.
And they should be going for one more on Beastmaster later on. Could even go for one on Lina if she ever gets farmed. But she's playing the 5 support or the bitch support in this game, so no farm for her. She hasn't earned. She should be happy. Oh, mid. They want to jump? That's pretty aggressive, though.
Yeah, we'll try KS was looking for a 4-step into a blink.
Yeah, Miracle forcing down KS, like, go! But that would have been terrible, because everyone is around mid.
5-Eva instead, just starting to divert up towards top lane, but Miracle actually not able to make it up the ramp to join his team. As Ursa is just wandering through. So.
I think 5-Eva are just respecting that they don't have the strongest team fight. So right now they're trying to play the split push game a little bit, try and play around
their
opponents.
They're so squishy as well.
Yes.
Like in a full 5-on-5 fight, anyone who gets stunned even once, I think, just dies instantly.
Pretty much. And they're trying to hide now. The army of Beastmasters kind of looking around. Oh, they might actually find them.
Oh, they've spotted Ysera in the trees. He's got a 4-staff. Can try and force TP. Looks like that's going to be the play. Can they stop him? They will with the Fissure. And Yamate jumps in and brings him down.
I'm not there, La.
He's not there. He's not there anymore at the very
definitely
least.
Not there anymore. Good scouting there by Beastmaster, making the most out of his summons, of course. And Net actually stealing the enemy Ancients here a little bit. And he's not really under vision while doing so, but they did see him go up there. And he's even taking the mid creep wave. So Net playing really greedy here, but he also knows what's there really to punish him right now. Nothing that can kill him when they have the Hawk here protecting him with vision.
Yeah, it feels like 5F are just kind of... Well, G-Guard at least are just playing Exterminators right now. They're just running around trying to find the rats hiding in their jungle looking for the pickoffs.
Oh, the smoke TP's coming in bottom. They're going to see if they can get an initiation with Shaker.
There's already a silence onto Yamate, but he doesn't care. He comes blinking in, pops the BKB. Miracle running back with the Windrun Force Staff as well. But he's going to end up getting Yules as the Fisher also flies. Looks like Windranger definitely taking a dirt nap. And that is going to be the end of this bottom lane. Tower does end up being brought down by the Windrunner in the meantime. So a bit of a trade, but still not what 5EVO were looking for.
They got something, but it's still bad, kind of. Yeah. And the smoke breaks here. They're running out to the shop. They use Zeus ulti to scout it. They could hex him.
Slow really reaction, slow. I think, from KS.
Yeah.
Must have been looking somewhere else.
Very slow.
BKB TP out. Nothing to cancel that.
Wow. Because that was like a full 1.5 seconds after the Zeus ulti that SF did not use BKB and was in range of Lion's Hex. So KS... Yeah.
I mean, he didn't know that he'd been scouted, but he didn't know that Lion was right around the corner. It's all on the Lion to...
Oh, yeah. That's what I mean. But yeah. As soon as
Winter looking to combo off a Pelosin here, they're going to get the Requiem from the high ground as well. Net.
The Roar.
First down one. And yeah, Roar onto Chibix. He also falls in just a matter of seconds. This is a double damage Ursa going to work.
Yeah, it's so hard, dude. It's pretty dangerous. And right now, I just feel like 5EVO are crumbling. They don't have any right clicker at all in their team because Bloodseeker went for this Dagon build and it's not working anymore. I think G-Guard are solidly going to take this game from here on unless there's a miracle for 5EVO.
And the scaling for 5EVO just doesn't feel like it addresses any of the fundamental issues that they're having right now.
I suppose they have the Aghanim's coming up now for Windrunner, so she will have some damage, but it's just not...
Damage isn't even the problem. It's survivability and control that I think is really giving 5EVO problems in these team fights. And for that, yeah, itemization can help a little bit, but their lineup just feels somewhat outclassed. They're up against Lightstrike Array and Fisher and Roar, and G-Guard have a lot of survivability, BKBs, mech, and even just Blink Dagger, so that the heroes that 5EVO actually want to go on that are a little bit squishier just start the fight from so far away. Like Ling at the moment is nowhere near being hurt by anyone on 5EVO, aside from the Zeus ultimate.
They're trying to go aggressive here, but didn't get the right click in on the line before he blinked. Very nice Queen. Just playing a creep wave. A little bit earlier though, because there's the next creep wave coming in. But they're still going to go and defend top, it seems. Miracle, is he going to go for a play here? I don't think there's much to be made. He gets a nice Shackle shot, but that's a super tanky target.
He's level 16. Yamate just needs to get the ultimate off here if he feels like he's in trouble. Miracle does manage to pop the Windrun. They're going to chain stun the Windranger here. And as the Windrun fades,
okay, that was crazy close. He almost got that, and at the same time, they did bring down the Beastmaster and stole the gem. So that's really massive. Bloodseeker now, fueled by the attempt on top lane, is really quick as well.
They come over to mid lane. They look towards Net. KS locking him down. Net in the lane with a few auto attacks, trying to turn this one. Would have been huge if he'd killed the Lion. Would have got a really big heal off of that. But just going to end up being the Aegis popped. And I think G-Guard just going to back up to their base and regroup for another attempt.
Five ever want to go, though. They want to go on the Shadow Fiend right now. Oh, okay.
Okay, blinks back to his team. Sonic Wave Bloodrite gets dropped on nothing. Comboed those creeps.
Net is like, what? I'm already gone, guys. Like, what are you doing? We'll see what Net picks up now. Okay, he's going into a Scotty most likely as he adds up the ultimate orb here. No other build really that you want. You just want the Scotty. The Snow is super good. And good stats as well.
KS is pretty happy with his point booster picked up. He's got the... Wait, is that the Stolen gem or did they buy
stolen.
One?
Stolen from...
No, they've got... There's two. So he has one, and I think the Bloodseeker has the Stolen Gem. Yeah.
Oh, that's true.
So they did buy one of their own to get a little bit of dewarding done. There isn't a single ward on the map right now for either team, but there is the Hawk wandering around for Ben somewhat.
It's fine. Vision is overrated, dude.
who needs it? In terms of actual wards and inventories, there's also none for 5EVA. The Chaos is going to be picking some up now. And Ling has one waiting there for him. So we should see a bit more vision established, or at least attempting to establish some more vision. I like this ward up on the high ground. I think Lina may have just light strike.
It's a good anti-gem ward.
Yeah, it's somewhat unlikely to be dewarded. You're always looking for those high ground spots or places that are covered in weird angles by fog or only give you the tiniest little sliver of vision. But anything that you can get is worth it.
Yeah, another D-ward going down here. So Radiant, again, down to having zero Observer wards. And we see the little Tinker ward as well here during the push. Along with the Hawk, just a lot of vision from the side here. Oh, Ursa going around, but he gets found.
Yeah, he's dead. Bursted down almost instantly. And now for G-Guard, they have to sound the retreat. But Ben gets ruptured up and then shackled to his own Necro Book, as Miracle's going to finish him off with a few more focus-fired auto-attacks. And Pelosin, deciding that he's not done just yet, is looking
Ling
for something over here in the jungle. Ling just going to be TPing out. Sonic Waves available, but Earthshaker is already back at the fountain, and he's going to be just fine.
He'll be just fine. I feel that was kind of unfortunate for Ursa. He made a very weird roll there, though, going around without the Beastmaster. He always wants to walk with the Beastmaster, because that's the reliable disable, and then Ursa will kill someone during that time. But he kind of ran around the corner with no vision there, ran into a lion, got hexed. And, you know, unlucky for him, the lion did have backup. It's not like they even saw the Ursa walk around. They just kind of ran into each other.
We have seen some attempts at making good use of the Blood Rage synergy this game, and I think that's something that we haven't necessarily seen as much from some of the past Bloodseeker games in this qualifier. Miracle actually finds another solo kill on net bottom, but he's going to get punished by a Dragon Slave into a Laguna Blade.
That's still good, though.
From Winter.
What the fuck?
He's not impressed.
Yeah,
he's like, Winter, why are you there? Net was out of position. He was my free kill.
Yeah.
But Winter had his back.
Miracle. Just going for every chance that he can get. Still good for him, though, because he got a solo kill on the enemy Shadow Fiend, which is huge. And then the enemy brought two heroes down there to kill him. So in terms of space creation, that's how you do it. You know, get a kill and then die with enemy investing more resources and time than you did, so that your team can farm more than the enemy team during this. It's just a good play still. Shadow Fiend, though, looking pretty good for farm with all of this. Looks like it's going to be the BKB build next for Windrunner, so no one can really stop him from focusing his target. Apart from Beastmaster, I suppose.
Kamatei runs forward, gets silenced here, but just going to slap down some illusions. Does he use a Sonic Wave? Ysera comes force staffing in, but that's his only method of escape. And Ursa is going to say thank you very much and finish him off.
I don't think you can aggressively force staff like that as Zeus, but he tried. They wanted to burst him. Yamate was holding on to his BKB for so long that Ysera thought that he could get his burst out as well before the BKB came. But he got baited by Yamate.
But Chaos coming in for round two, makes the attempt, but doesn't quite have the range.
God, this is so awkward to watch now. He's going to get killed for sure here.
It's like, okay, yeah, I accept this. that was my bad.
And that's a gem that he gave back to the enemy team as well. Nice TP out here. Going to make it at least the Bloodseeker. As Beastmaster doesn't have a blink dagger yet and couldn't really get in range.
That's one of those just, oh man, I screwed up kind of moments.
Like, blink in and you only get in range for the creeps and you stand there like a Dumbo.
I accept my fate.
And Ursa now starting to build towards that MKB, gonna counter the
Windrunner. Definitely needs it.
Yeah.
Do you think one for the Shadow Fiend as well, or does he look towards maybe Butterfly now? I know that Windrunner is gonna be able to buy up an MKB at some stage if he goes for the Butterfly, but it still seems like a decent item. What do you think?
I think you should go for... that's tough, actually, the next item for Shadow Fiend. That's not that easy to say. I think Satanic is pretty fine. There's so much one burst damage on the side of 5EVA. You have the Queen ulti, or the Finger. Like, a lot of these things they use, and if you can just regen through it afterwards, then you're going to be good to push high ground. Because that's pretty much what they need to itemize for now, is like being able to break high ground against 5EVA. I think Satanic is probably the best choice here. Adding more damage doesn't really make sense when you have Lina and Ursa in your team. You just need to be tanky, I think.
Okay, yeah, I can follow that line of thinking for sure. What else have we got? Chaos has almost picked up a Aghanim Scepter on his line. He's also almost got level 16, so some big plays potential coming out there. The smoke has been revealed over on Yamate, but he's waiting for the rest of his team to get in position. The Hex does come out, but the Fisher counter-initiates, and
he just picked up the gem on the courier, and now he loses it again.
It's the exact
was this
same
the
story.
Second gem, actually?
It might have been, yeah.
I think it was...
Let's have a quick look at the item panel. So I think gem on the Earthshaker belongs to Ben, and the gem on the Beastmaster belongs to Chaos. So, yeah, so there's only two gems in the game, but they've now both been passed over to G-Guard.
Yeah.
Both by Lion.
In within the time span of like 90 seconds, his team must be looking at like now, right now. Like
I actually just want to look at how that affects the net worth.
It doesn't show.
Oh, it's not on gems.
No, it doesn't show on net worth.
Okay,
Divine Rapier does, I believe, but the gem doesn't.
Okay, that's a little bit inconsistent, but
I suppose it doesn't. Or maybe it doesn't, it's just the other golds affecting, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't. Okay, Ursa just slapping down.
Comes in out of nowhere, just slaps down the Bloodseeker.
He had cooldown on his Silver's Edge because he was using it to maneuver, I guess. But yeah, no survivability. That's where Miracle a Yule Scepter would have looked mighty
here,
fine.
Gonna get roared. Necrobook coming out as well from Ben. No one else here just yet to help him out. But there is Winter coming around the corner.
Mana burn just barely burning enough for him not to be able to use Windrun.
Nice Orchid from Pelosin. Actually gonna keep him safe here as unable to drop any further stuns, but Yamate is still able to keep on chasing.
This is the downside. When you blink away, some heroes can just blink pursue you as a Queen of Pain. And meanwhile, actually, they even get a kill on KS again, dying for the third time in like 4 minutes.
I love the back and forth between KS and Net this game. They've given Net a really hard time, and in return, I think he's now giving
is
KS.
Sera dying as well, so all five of five ever just dying in succession here. Buyback being forced out by Zeus, I think that's a good buyback. He knows that someone has to go back and defend these high grounds. There's still half a minute on multiple of his teammates.
And they do have a glyph, actually.
So buybacking as soon as possible is good. It makes you have your buyback ready as soon as possible later on.
Yeah. But Zeus trying to hold onto the high ground, but Yamate comes running in, pops everything, four hits.
All right.
Finishes off the Zeus. Chibix is going to get locked down, and
it's only
a few more to finish off the Bloodseeker. And Net teaming up there, and as you said, that may very well be it for 5EVA here.
Yamate, no fear, just forcing down. I don't know. I think that the Dagon Bloodseeker is now 50% win rate in professional games.
The first
Dagon,
item.
Dagon level 1 Bloodseeker. Or like Dagon Rush, I should say. And we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Maybe someone will come in and redeem it later on.
Well, we'll have to see. Chaos just getting chased back again by Net here. A couple more auto attacks to finish him off. Pelosin gets chopped by the Beastmaster.
Trying to TP up
a
whole five or alive here on G-Guard. So very tough to go into that fight.
There's going to be a Monkey King bar for Net, but I don't think he... Is he even going to end up getting that one delivered in time? It's making its way out right now, but...
Yeah, so much items on that courier. Courier coming with like 10k net worth.
Let's go, Chibix. Let's Blood Rage up this Zeus. Let's drop some damage.
Yeah,
what
are
you going
to try? I mean, you have to try.
Yeah, Thunder God's Wrath comes out. Pelosin goes jumping in as well. He's Blood Rage taking lots of damage, but turnarounds, looks for the Sonic Wave. Gets a bit of a heal, I think, off the Lina kill.
That was really nice. He healed up because of it, yeah.
Bloodseeker lifted towards the air. They do manage to bring down Net as well. Ysera actually laying into everyone on G-Guard. And that's a triple kill for your Zeus. Yamate just playing the objective, hitting away at the racks. Just going to take one or two more auto attacks to finish it.
Yamate?
Wait, come on, Yamate. There's 40 health on the building.
Killed the building, Yamate.
Oh, never mind.
What the fuck?
He's there, like, I'm going to deny it.
I like how he hits it once.
Wait, how much health does it have now?
Four.
Four health.
It had 40, and he killed 36.
This game got clowny pretty quickly. Chibix is zapping out over on Winter. Gives him the buff. That's not what you want to do. He's still going to play it to the face.
Oh my gosh. When you start denying for your own mega creeps. Wow, this guy, spoiler.
Okay, I think both of these teams are just having a little bit of fun.
Yeah, they're just playing it out. They want to have fun. Boys just want to have fun, dude.
Earthshaker picking up his Shadow Blade here. Ling's gonna go running out looking for some solo kills. He bought back and bought the Shadow Blade.
I don't know what Yamato was thinking there when he TP'd out. He's like, yep, that should do it. I'll just...
brushed my hands off. It's been a hard day's work.
48 HP rain tracks. My job is done.
Oh, well. I want Ling to go and just run over into the Radiant base and
turn
him at once and finish it off.
Pretty sure your Zero is going to run up and deny the top rack soon.
Okay, Net comes in once again. I think he's looking for KS here. He's going to get Yules up, drop down, stunned up, finished off. Another Yules. Ling looking for the chain stun as the Requiem and the Echo Slam. Blow up Miracle and
so
KS.
So many ultis, la.
Looks like he's had enough. That's going to be the GG well
played. Go, you Sierra. Deny.
Deny the racks.
Deny.
Get it.
Deny. Oh,
no.
Deny.
Come on.
Deny.
He's not going to do it.
Oh, my God. They're holding on. Okay, he's selling everything to buy Refresher. He doesn't have the money. This is kind of awkward. Get a creep,
it's
dude.
Okay, more creeps. More creeps.
Get some for him.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's pretty... pretty convincing performance though this game. Like, I really like to see G-Guard go for the Ursa here, and I think Yamato played it really well.
Yeah,
like the way they used it, because he had a really tough laning stage and then he recovered so well.
Oh my god, that 80% damage reduction. Yamato
is taking
no damage. The fountain at the moment.
Yeah.
They're gonna wipe them all out. G-Guard end this game in style, and it looks like that should be that for
Five
this
Eva
two could
have ended
series.
It in style by denying their own racks, dude.
Deny the racks, call the GG.
Mega creeps,
yeah.
And then just, you know, sell items for Refresher. It's good times. Well, that does it for this series. So we have another 2-0 G-Guard, 2-0-ing 5-Eva. Of course, 2-0s are worth a lot of points. You guys have been watching a lot of games now, so you probably know this.
Everyone knows about that at this stage.
Of course, of course. Everyone is hardcore.
Yeah. So, I don't know. Game 2, I thought 5-Eva were looking all right out of the laning phase. They had the... They had the Windrunner Ancients going on, Miracle running around, landing
Miracle
some jackal shots, getting things done, but...
I think Miracle was fine this game. I just think that everything else was just failing for them. They didn't really get much on Lion at all, 3, 9, and 3. When he had his Blink Dagger, he like blinked into the enemy the first thing he did and just fed. He blinked kind of blindly onto one target and he had two friends around.
Did he sell his Blink for the Aghanim Scepter
at the
end? He
did as well, yes. There's 4 Aghanim Scepters on the side of Radiant. Definitely sold some items. And I don't think the Dagon Rush on Bloodseeker was good at any point or stage in this game. Like, Yule Scepter is so damn good for Bloodseeker. You have to understand how much of a difference it makes on the third skill. Increasing your base movement speed and then being able to increase that with the third skill
is
massive.
Reliable combos for Bloodrite, a way to cancel TPs if people are trying to escape from Rupture.
You mess with people like the Earthshaker as well, as he has the Blink Dagger and wants to escape. You can maybe just use him, put down the Bloodrite as you said, and just beat him down from that point as he's silenced. But, you know, at least they went for it. They're the first team to lose with Bloodseeker. It's always got to be
ruining the win rate. There's always that one guy.
So 7-1, I believe now is the score. Unless some other game has finished with Bloodseeker as well, but I don't think so. Of course, I wouldn't be watching other games during our cast here.
Little pitcher in pitcher going on, keeping tabs on.
I wouldn't mind that. That would be fine. But that's the series.
Yeah, that's gonna wrap it up. Is this your last cast?
I think it
might be. This is your last scheduled cast.
This
perhaps.
Is my last scheduled cast. I might join
in.
We
sometime. Might see some more.
My voice is kind of, you know, and I'm not being paid to cast. I'm just a couch potato here at the stream. I just want to be on the Mango stream. Thank you, production. Love you, too. We'll see. Maybe I join more. If Mango stream wants to get rid of me, I'll run out and cast.
Okay, cool. Well, thank you guys very much for watching here on TI5 Yasha. We've got more SEA qualifier coverage coming up relatively soon, so don't go too far, and I'll see you then.